Hello. Yes, we're having way too much fun, and the segment hasn't even started with the farm boy. Folks, pumpkin season is in full swing. Plenty of great recipes that can help your dishes shine during this season's Halloween parties. So joining us from Farm Boy, Executive Chef Josh, Product Development Chef Liam. Good morning.
Good morning. Yay. Thanks for having us back.
Thanks for coming on. Yeah, we always look forward to these segments. And we are starting with pumpkin-themed appetizers for our Halloween
party. For our Halloween party.
Yeah.
Put on your masks and let's go. So we got Liam, who got us here a little bit late today.
You've been giving him a hard time
about
that.
A little bit of a hard time.
You have difficulty with time management.
Time management is the word you're looking for.
I don't work in restaurants anymore.
So what we're doing is we're going to make a kind of a Halloween cheese ball. So
Liam's, ooh, I love it.
Yeah, it's actually really nice. So Liam's got some goat cheese and some cream cheese that he's put in the bowl.
Okay.
You're going to put some of our delicious, fresh Farm Boy salsa in that.
Ooh, love this.
And some cheddar cheese. And then he's going to mix that up super quick.
It smells so great.
Yeah,
oh,
the salsa is awesome.
Yeah, it's delicious.
So you just mix it up really nicely.
Okay, and so then
And what you do is you grab your handy dandy melon ball, ice cream scoop.
Look at the size.
That's a nice melon ball.
And you scoop it out.
You got to refrigerate it for like at least 30 minutes. And then what you do is you're going to have your nice cheddar cheese here. Just try and get a little bit messy.
Okay.
And then you just kind of just try and shape it.
And the idea, obviously, is to make this look like a pumpkin, right?
Yeah.
It's like I've done this with you guys before.
Yeah. And then what you do is you take a bell pepper top.
Okay.
And you sort of pierce it in the center.
How cute is
it's
that?
It's super cute.
That is very cute. Okay, and then you're serving it with the...
We're going to put some blue corn chips on it.
Okay.
And kind of give it like a nice sort of...
How fun is that?
I love this.
Yeah, and really easy.
And not a whole lot of time in the kitchen, and you look like you were working for a while on this. Yeah, fantastic.
Make it ahead.
Okay, let's talk about another delicious appetizer here. So the smoked salmon and guacamole on toasted naan bread.
So we've got our naan bread, which we've toasted, but it's also nice if you put it in a frying pan with a little bit of olive oil.
Okay.
And Liam is ever so fancily making a quenelle of guacamole.
What is a... That's what a quenelle is?
That is a quenelle.
Ooh, yeah. So that you're not just spreading it on really messy.
No, because Liam's fancy.
Liam's
fancy.
Super fancy. This is how he rolls.
Fancy and late. That's how Liam rolls. Fancy and late.
You are not going to live that down.
No, you still
made this segment. It's all great. Okay, so that looks terrific.
A little bit of smoked salmon on there.
Just
to finish off, just like a nice little... chilled radish.
You are fancy. Chilled radish, even. Never mind room temperature
radish.
Here's the thought, Trisha, if you have a room temperature radish.
No, exactly.
It has to be chilled.
That is totally taboo. Okay, our last one. Stuffed vegetarian endive.
Yeah. So Liam's going to grab the...
sun-dried tomatoes.
Sun-dried tomatoes.
Ooh. Sun-dried tomatoes. I was going to say, is it a bit of
sun-dried tomatoes.
Okay.
A bit of muffuletta.
Yum.
What is that?
Delicious.
It's chopped
up. What is in there?
Oh.
Muffuletta?
Go ahead.
Yeah, carrots, olives, a bit of chopped up cauliflower in there as well. It's just sort of soaked in salt,
kind of like
oil.
It's like salt brine, salt pickle,
I guess.
It's delicious.
And you kind of just, what you're going to be doing is just sort of mixing it together.
Okay.
And then you have your little bit of your endives here.
Your endives.
Is that how you say it?
No,
is
that's
that
not the, how you say it.
Was I right with endives?
No, but Liam spent time in Ongland, where he spoke Onglish.
Late
room temperature radishes and endives.
He told me to say that.
Endive. Because I even asked you before the segment how you pronounce it.
Yeah.
The two of you are hilarious. Oh, they just don't even need me here.
So this looks terrific.
Got that guy. A little bit of sour cream.
Ooh.
And like, how nice is that? And it's super easy,
beautiful,
right? And you can make them ahead.
Yes.
Great. And your guests think that you've spent all day in the kitchen.
Exactly.
Liam spent all day in the kitchen.
Liam helped us out with all of this.
With the little caper berries.
I like to be fancy
as well. That's super cute.
Caper berries, too. Now, are they chilled slightly?
No. The caper berry, you want to temper a little bit.
Room
temperature caper berry, chilled radish. Oh. Imperative to the
appetizers. Okay, good to know. Okay, can I, like, dig in?
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
All right, this will be all over me.
This guy will be delicious,
right? Oh, okay. Is this your favorite? Are we all going to eat?
I love guacamole.
I'm going to have a jube.
I'm going to have one.
Okay. Coming up next, wow, I'm talking with my mouth full now. We're going to do dessert. So that'll be exciting. You want to stay tuned?